this is what a cartola looks like. We have to just get these prickly parts out. It seems like a lot of work, but it's pretty fun. You can cut them in rings or you can cut them halfway through like this. We're just going to massage these so that the big seeds kind of get dislodged. They won't taste so good. So these big seeds will come off by just massaging them like this. We start with the onions. You can cook oil-free if you're using the right cookware. So I'm using earthenware. It's a clay pot. You can achieve the same with a stainless steel pot. As you can see, the onions are well roasted now. I'm just going to add a green chili. I've just split it into half and I'm adding that for spice. I can even crush it a bit. I'm now going to add the chopped up cartoli or cantola. If you get a tender one, the seeds will barely be visible. This is not as tender. I'm going to cover it, let it just get some steam for a few seconds. We're just going to open this and add a wee bit of water and cover it again. So after about 5 minutes, and it depends on how tender your cantola was, the vegetable is now cooked. I'm going to add haldi now. It's a good idea sometimes to add the haldi later, especially when we don't know how much the vegetable will shrink and become less in quantity. I'm going to add salt now and give it a mix. If your cartoli is tender, it would cook a little faster. Mine was not so tender, so it took a little over 5 minutes. And now to finish this off, I'm going to add some coconut. This is our good fat going in. And roasted crushed peanuts. This will also add a much needed fat as well as awesome flavor. And at the end, I'm going to switch off the flame and add lemon juice for flavor and vitamins. And that's it. This is our cartoli sabzi ready.